for his work with that in his films. His name is Peter Jackson.
It's the original Peter Hoffman that made me want to direct movies. I saw that movie on TV when I was about 8 or 9 years old. I wanted to be one of them. I like the ones that just take you away from the world. I sweep you up into the edge of college, which does it when you're on the ship, you're sailing to a lost island, you're encountering monsters and creatures from, you know, prehistoric times. I was thrilled for Universal to have the effect of a great movie. And they've created this 3D experience. You have to have your glasses ready. Don't put them on yet, but just have them in your hand because we're about to return to Skull Island. We really put a lot of thought into the personality of him. He's so much more than a monster. In fact, he's not a monster. You know, he is an incredibly majestic, ancient creature. He's a force of nature. He's old, he's wise, he's proud, he's fierce, and obviously he has a heart. The most important feature with Kong are his eyes. Kong's eyes are wonderfully expressive. They're full of emotion. His eyes are like a window into his personality. He's had an enormous number of encounters with his foes, the T-Rexes and the various dinosaurs on Skull Island, so he's been beaten up, scarred, chewed up, spat out by these dinosaurs at various times, and he wears the scars of a lot of ancient battles. The Universal Tram is winding its way through a very rough, narrow trail in Skull Island, allowing the visitors a little sneak peek at some of the wildlife of Skull Island. In a sense, this is like a mini sequel, a mini continuation. We're just taking the Kong and Skull Island and the dinosaurs that we established in our feature film. And this is, another day, another incident on Skull Island, using the creatures and the character and personality of Kong as he appeared in the movie. Skull Island.